Aberrant ventricular conduction is a common electrocardiographic manifestation that occurs when the supraventricular electrical impulse is conducted abnormally through the ventricular conduction system. This results in a white Keras complex. That may be confused with a ventricular ectopic beat. This differentiation is important because the treatment and prognosis is quite different. Look at action potential of ventricular conduction system. There are five phases which are related to ion currents. Phase 0 is rapid upstroke and depolarization due to opening of voltage-gated sodium channels. Phase 1 is initial repolarization, represented by inactivation of voltage-gated sodium channels and activation of voltage-gated potassium channels. Phase 2 is plateau, related to the calcium influx through the calcium channels and potassium efflux. Phase 3 is rapid repolarization, represented by massive potassium efflux due to opening of voltage-gated potassium channels and closure of voltage-gated calcium channels. Phase 4 is resting potential. Duration of action potential consists of absolute and relative refractory periods. From the beginning of zero phase to beginning of third phase is absolute refractory period. It means all stimuli that arrive at this period are blocked. But during the third phase, the action potential of cardiac cells has a relative refractory period. During relative refractory period, a second action potential can be evoked, but only if the stimulus strength is increased. But normal impulse can't be conducted. In the fourth stage, any normal impulse can be conducted. The ventricular conduction system begins to branch from the His bundle to form left bundle branch and right bundle branch. Also, refractory period of right and left His branches are not equal. The right bundle branch has longer action potential and refractory period. This is a key mechanism that causes ventricular aberrancy. So, if the stimulus arrives at the time when the left bundle branch went out of refractory period, but right bundle branch still has refractory period, the stimulus can be propagated through the right bundle branch due to refractory period, but easy pass through the left bundle branch because it has not refractory period. As a result, functional block of right bundle branch or aberrancy occurs, and YKRS complex has a right bundle branch morphology. The aberrant conduction depends on the relative refractory period of conduction tissues. Duration of relative refractory period depends on action potential duration, which depends on the heart rate. Changes of heart rate reflect on ACG SRR interval. So the duration of action potential and refractory period changes with the RR interval of the preceding cycle. Shorter duration of action potential and shorter refractory period are associated with a short RR interval. And prolonged duration of action potentials and refractory period are associated with a long RR interval. A longer cycle lengthens the ensuing refractory period. And if the shorter cycle follows the beat ending, it is like to be conducted with aberrancy. Example of this condition is Ashman phenomena. Ashman phenomena is an aberrant ventricular conduction due to change in QRS cycle lengths that are represented as RR interval. If a sudden lengthening of QRS cycle occurs, the subsequent impulse with a normal or shorter cycle length may be conducted with aberrancy. So for Ashman phenomena should be long, short RR interval seconds. There are three main conditions that lead to aberrant conduction. Short pre-ectopic interval according to the previous RR interval. Long previous RR interval according to the next normal RR interval. Due to the critical fast rate when RR is too short and next stimulus arrived before the end of refractory period of previous cycle. The vast majority of aberrancy is represented as right bundle branch block morphology. But 20% cases have a left bundle branch block morphology. Rules that characterize supraventricular premature beat with aberrancy. The strongest rule is the presence of P wave, because all of aberrant complexes has a supraventricular region, therefore should have activation of atria, that is represented as P wave. If you find P wave before the white caress complex, this is the strongest sign of aberrancy. P wave can be hidden in previous T wave or ST segment. Other rules can help but not so strong. QRS duration is less than 120 milliseconds. Not full compensatory pulse. If you have a left bundle branch block morphology, it should have fast S peak in V1. Absence of Q wave in V6. If you have right bundle branch block morphology, QRS should have three phases in V1, and in V6 S wave is smaller than R wave. If you like the content, press like and subscription buttons. Have a good day. Here we go.